Well, as the investigation into last week's terror attack in Spain continues, it emerged on Monday that all but one of the suspects are Moroccan citizens. And now questions are being asked about the risk terror cells in Morocco pose to countries in Europe. Youssef Sharif is a political analyst. He joins me now to discuss this from Tunis. Thanks so much for joining us on TRT World. First of all, does Morocco have a problem with terrorist cells on its territory that also threaten European countries? Or is the problem with Moroccans already living in Europe who become radicalized there?
Well, it's both ways. Morocco, like most Arab countries today, face an issue of radicalized youth, youth who are losing their identity and who are looking for a new identity, but also youth who have economic problems. And so they are looking for something else that can take them out of the issues where they found themselves today. This is the Arab and Muslim world's version of what is happening in Europe and the United States and the rest of the world, where the youth do not know what to do and how to solve it. So sadly, in the Arab and Muslim world in general, they move towards radicalism. And same thing with the youth from the same origins in Europe. Many of them get radicalized very quickly in Europe, and usually through imams who are already radical, they are trapped to do actions like what we've seen in Las Ramblas. But be it in Morocco, North Africa, the rest of the region, or in Europe, most often you find youth who are very quickly, very recently radicalized, who were not radicalized forever. So very often these are thugs, criminals, petty criminals usually, who've been to jail for small things, who get radicalized in sometimes even 1 month, and okay, who are tempted into such actions.
Is there anything unique, though, about what Morocco faces compared to other countries, its neighbors in North Africa?
Actually, unique, no, I won't say unique, because the closest country to Morocco in this would be Tunisia. Both countries are sending lots of young people to, or at least used to send a lot of young people to Syria and Iraq to fight for this jihad. And both countries went through a democratic transition, although in Tunisia it's a much successful democratic transition than in Morocco. But if you recall the discussions we had about Tunisia, it's very similar to what we're talking today about for Morocco. So I won't call it unique, but I think what's happening in Morocco has been hidden for many reasons, mainly the good PR PR work that the Moroccan state has been conducting. But now the world is discovering that Morocco, like the other Arab countries, has this same issue.
Okay. Youssef Sharif, we will leave it there for now. Thank you so much for joining us.